The Executor has an interesting unique ability. Every time you hit all the bullets on a target, it grants you Executor's Exaltation, which increases accuracy, firearm critical hit rate, firearm critical hit damage, fire rate, and weak point damage. At 3 stacks, this weapon can reach up to 100% firearm critical hit rate, which is insanely good. Not only that, it also gives the target a debuff called Executor's Purge, which increases your firearm damage, and it also decreases the target's defense. As of right now, the only descendant that can effectively use this weapon is Glay, since she has an ability called Super Sense, which grants her infinite ammo. This weapon is indeed powerful, but it just doesn't have the ammo reserved for prolonged fights. For the build, let's start with the weapon readjustment option. Go for weak point damage, firearm attack, bonus firearm attack versus Colossus, and firearm critical hit damage. The first build is for invasion infiltration operations, 400% invasion missions, and regular missions. For the modules, I'm using action and reaction and rifling reinforcement, increasing firearm attack by 93%. For the firearm critical hit damage, these are the modules that I'm using: concentration priority, better concentration, concentrate support ammo, fire rate concentration, hit rate focus, and focus fire. All in all, the total firearm critical hit damage is increased by 94.6%. The base firearm critical hit damage of this weapon is 1.1 times. Adding all the modules and the weapon readjustment option increases it from 1.1 to 2.259 times. Concentrate support ammo also increases rounds per magazine by 30%, so from 8 rounds to 10. Fire rate concentration increases fire rate by 20%, so from 109 to 136. Hit rate focus increases accuracy by 30%, which helps tighten the bullet spread in a small spot. This is quite handy in invasion missions or 400% missions because it makes the bullet spread tighter and at the same time making it easy to gain its unique ability, Executor's Exaltation. Lastly, focus fire increases weak point damage by 20%. The base weak point damage of this weapon is 1 times. Adding the module and the weapon readjustment option increases it from 1 times to 1.3 times. For the last two sockets, I'm using Shell Up, which increases the number of pellets from 15 to 19. And for the last module, depending on the faction that you are fighting, use the appropriate bullet improvement. If you are fighting Legion of Darkness, then use Chill Enhancement. If you are fighting against Order of Truth, then use Electric Enhancement. And for Legion of Immortality, use Toxic Enhancement. You can actually tell which bullet enhancement to use by simply looking at the faction's color. Red is fire, so it is weak to chill. Green is weak to electric, and blue is weak to toxic. For the Void Intercept Battle or Colossus boss fight, the only module that you need to change is Focus Fire and replace it with Weak Point Sight. Also, let me remind you again that the only descendant that can wield this weapon efficiently is Glay, since she can manipulate the ammo. And if you are looking for a detailed Glay build, I have a link in the description down below. Also, this weapon is kind of hard to use against the latest boss, Deathstalker, since Glay doesn't have any shields. However, all the other bosses are viable. All in all, this weapon is pretty fun to use, and this is by far the best shotgun in the game. The only downside is that only Glay can use it effectively because of the lack of ammo reserve. I hope the devs increase the ammo reserve for this weapon because it is just not enough, especially when the target is a massive bullet sponge. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.